Anonymous says, what are your recommendations on magnesium supplements and dosage? Would you mix low mag, which is magnesium chloride and calcium for absorption, electrolyte balance, and magnesium oxide or glycinate to help with bowel function? Or sprays like Ease or Ancient Minerals? I've used a bunch of this stuff, and at the end of the day, my opinion is that most people shouldn't be supplementing with high doses of magnesium. And I think if you're going to supplement with more than 400 milligrams a day, you should be testing your magnesium status and you should be making decisions on that. I think there's way too many people throwing really high doses of magnesium into their system. The topical stuff makes sense if you're not absorbing it poorly, but hey, maybe you're not absorbing it poorly because you don't need it. And so I think you really have to judge it against like real metrics of results. And this light, let's see, is lighting better like this? Maybe it is. Okay. I think you have to judge it against real metrics of results, and that's that. So in terms of types, I would not recommend magnesium oxide for anything. It's poorly absorbed, so maybe you could argue that magnesium oxide is going to help act as a laxative better, but that's not bowel function. That's like pharmacologically modulating your bowel transit time. So I like, look, I don't think it makes sense to deliberately take a poorly absorbed magnesium to have that effect. I think you should take, like, the good sources of magnesium are magnesium citrate is okay, glycinate is okay, malate is okay. All across the board, like, I genuinely don't believe that the dose is that, I mean, that the form is that important. It's just that oxides of minerals, including magnesium, are generally poorly absorbed. But there's not that much difference in the other forms, I don't think. And yeah, tailor it to the individual. I wouldn't give blanket recommendations there.